Mini chapter 62, Dud shocked in the motel by the liquor store. Meanwhile, Dud exits the 110 freeway, curves off the ramp and proceeds along Century Boulevard. Soon, he's doubling back along 99th, until he reaches a place where he coasts to a halt and parks. He peers across the street at the sad little motel by the liquor store. Its pale façade is almost featureless, except for two irregular rows of tiny bathroom windows. He gets out, presses his key fob, and hears his car's lock beep behind him. Rounding the corner of Vermont, he comes to the building's front gateway. He starts in recognition. Is that the girl he saw in the photograph ahead of him right now, flitting up the steps to the open walkway of the motel's upper level, glancing back down at him with laughing eyes full of sassy flirtation and sunlight? She disappears from his view as she crests the top step and runs on along the walkway, triggering his memory of that other gaze stabbing into him from behind her face. And along with this advent of Evelyn, Jamie's perceptions come swinging down from the house on Electra Drive to here in Westmont. So distracted has he been by Kim's inner life, he's been forgetting to attend to her and Amber. Ignoring the opaque grilled windows of the motel's ground floor office on his left, Dud starts barreling up the flight of steps in pursuit of her. By the time he has heaved himself up to the upper walkway, it's deserted. One of the blue-grey doors on the left appears to be open just a crack, though. He runs along to the door, grabs its handle, and pushes it inwards. After the light outside, the interior is too dim for him to make out what's ahead, but sensing no immediate danger, he walks in and peers around. Intent on making visual sense of what's in the middle of the room, he hardly notices the door click shut behind him. Hanging from the ceiling is a pig's rib cage. A photo of his own face is stuck atop the rib cage, wearing a Righteous Gun cockpit cap. Hanging off the whole contraption is a dark, squeezy bag of blood by the look of it, while a lighted altar candle is stuck onto the floor on each side. Up on Electra Drive, seeing through the echo of Evelyn's presence here, Jamie's eyes widen with almost as great a surprise as Dud's. Dud staggers back and tries to leave the motel room, but the door has been locked. He gives up wrenching at the door handle. On the verge of panic, he spots a dusty landline telephone on a shelf near the door, dives for it, and jabs the zero button. He holds the old plastic handset to his ear, but can hear no ringing sound at the other end, so slams it back down onto the cradle. He tugs at the window bars in vain, while darting his eyes about the room, hunting for any kind of key. He bangs on the door and shouts. No answer. Nobody appears. And the squeezy bag of blood turns slowly in the air, spun around by the heat from the candles underneath.